Hello everybody, my name is Zach Roseman, and today we're going to be watching episodes 7 and 8 of Barry, the last two episodes of season 1. I am excited, and I'm also tired, because I have been editing several 2-hour movie reactions, 3-hour movie reaction, Oppenheimer, which, after recording this video, it's out already, which, yay, go watch that one. And I also got to record another reaction in a couple of days to an album, but that's to the Heart of an Artist Resurrection album. Why? Extra content. I am excited because I remember some of episodes 7 and 8 of Barry. I know the main plot points that happened. I just don't remember half the episode outside of those plot points. So let's see if it's worth the hype. Without further ado, let's go to episode 7 of Barry. That was so unnecessary. Like I said last video, they are fucking idiots. Oh, title card? Yep. Barry. Chapter 7, loud, fast, and keep going. Also, I'm just now realizing, I don't think they ever do the chapter thing again. I know they do the title thing throughout the episodes, but I don't think they just do chapter 1 or 2. After this season.
A bum rush? Ve por ellos, go, go.
Cristobal is hands down one of my favorite underrated characters of the show. Because you see, at first glance, he seems like the typical mob boss, but again, Barry subverts that trope and makes Cristobal an actual, like, layered character, and he's not really relevant until seasons 2 through 4. Oh god. They got fucked up.
If you wanted in on my stash house, all you had to do was call me.
He's angry. I can't tell.
You know, I have been a fan of yours for a while.
I love this dynamic of where the fucking mob families, all the leaders of the mob families just like each other and big fans of each other. Like, it's a really cool way of, like, subverting that whole trope of, oh, mob boss equals evil. I mean, there's still evil people can say, you know, kill. But at the same time, they show that they're still human. Also, is he wearing that same, like, wristband thing that Barry was wearing in the first episode? I don't know.
You were bloodthirsty maniac.
Whoever told you that is just wrong.
You need to kill Fuchs.
I mean, you just assume.
Oh, I forgot that's how they turn on Fuchs again. Fucking turns out Cristobal's a nice guy.
Oh. Yeah, it's a war now.
War?
Just so casually saying it's a war. Like, hey, we're on war now, man.
Hey, we gotta go. We gotta go. Come on. No. Pick that up. Pick that up. We'll get rid of it. Come on.
Just casually stealing the bike while fucking having your traumatized friend pick up a gun. That's friendship goals, people. I'm kidding.
Which of your guys, you know how this shit goes? Man,
oh, you fucking idiots. Why did y'all use that? Why did y'all use a phone they can trace y'all with?
I think Ryan was involved with the mob.
What?
Oh, also, we changed the scene. I'm Macbeth and your line is different.
What?
I have almost forgot. The taste of fears.
I completely forgot that she changed roles. I have not seen the show since I recorded 5 and 6. Also, this part does not matter.
Cannot once start me.
I gotta go. My queen, the lord, my lord, the queen is dead.
That's not, I can't.
Oh my god. She wants to have several opportunities, and she's able to pick up where she leaves off. But as soon as Barry messes up, she's like, ah, fuck that, I'm done. Fuck it, throw in the towel. Ooh.
Saucers, a little blood in your hair, that's a nice touch. Are you on drugs, Barry?
Yes.
A little story to illustrate.
Oh my god, again with the stories. He always tells a story.
Mr. Kuzno, I'm not on drugs.
You're not?
No.
Well, then that's very bad news for you.
Every actor has to be on drugs and slowly ruin their career because of it.
Because it's...
And that's sadly a true statement from Hollywood.
Unfucking lying? Then maybe this is not for you.
This man is stressed the fuck out because his best friend got involved in something he shouldn't have been. Yeah, he shot a guy and is messing up. He's continuously calling him. And now he has to do this one line or else he is completely fucked out of acting class. And this whole show is for nothing. He's just like, his head is just boo-hoo.
Okay, just slow down. We need to connect them to each other.
Oh yeah, I forgot. They make it look like Taylor was the one that was working for, like, the mob and, Ryan.
Sweetest kid you ever seen.
I went to the store this morning
to buy a babka, and I saw a man there. And just for a second, I thought...
I completely forgot about this scene. I did not know they had a scene together. In season one, at least.
So, no matter where you go, we will find you and kill you.
Dude.
So, Felix is fucked. Well, he would have been fucked.
Taylor is born.
This is hands down the best scene in the entire show. Because it pretty much shows... Barry's morals and how he's forced to just kill people because he, Chris wouldn't stay quiet. And this is really is where Bill Hader's acting from here to the part where he smashes the mirror. That's where his acting really shines here.
Kill the guy, okay? Now you might be cool with this shit, but I'm not. I got a wife and I got a kid, okay? And then she fucking knew. She knew.
He has come a long way since Freddy vs. Jason, and I really wish he was in more stuff. He's a great actor.
I'd do some time, fine. But I'm coming clean.
The worst decision you could ever make when you're with Barry.
Fucking Facebook.
Why'd you just say that?
I think the fucked up part about this, too, is he realizes that Barry's gonna kill him. Like, he full-on realizes it and tries to backtrack himself. But, too late.
I know you're not gonna do anything crazy, Barry.
How do you know that? You have barely known each other since y'all, like, rekindled. How do you know he won't hurt you?
I'm gonna keep my fat trap shut. And then, you know, I promise you, no one will...
I also love, like, the whole process Barry goes through with his face. Like, he's trying to be like, oh my god, do I kill him? Do I not kill him? If I kill him, I get more people onto me. If I don't kill him, he tells the cops, he kills the acting class, he kills Sally, and he can't have that. Because that's what he wants. So he just comes up with this.
We'll ever know any. Wait.
I remember my jaw was on the ground when I saw this scene for the first time. Because it was so, like, yeah, you were probably expecting that he was going to kill Chris. But at the same time, you don't want him to kill him because you want him to turn a new leaf. You want him to be this guy he's been trying to be throughout the entirety of the series so far. But as you come to learn throughout the rest of the series, Barry doesn't learn his goddamn lesson and does shit like this.
Crucible! Ladies and gentlemen, welcome. Recently...
Oh, God. Do I have to sit through this entire fucking play?
We have a saying in Italy. You make your bed.
That must have felt good.
The queen, my lord, is dead.
Oh, I think you can tell it's like a flashback. Not a flashback, like a dream sequence. Because the audience is different.
Look at me. Here's what's happening.
How can you not tell he's not in the right headspace for this shit? Like, you can clearly tell something's bothering him, but of course, Sally's just like,
Money, acting!
Uh-oh. Clearly tell something's wrong with him. Like, why? I mean, I get why, because Sally's self-centered. But come on.
My lord. The queen is dead.
Fucking chills.
Out, brief candle.
This monologue is great. I like the Macbeth play in general, but at the same time, I kind of checked out halfway through Macbeth.
Yay!
I don't know if you can do it again, but it was a mess. Ah! Okay, I see you're still in that place. I'm going to leave you to your process. You know, I have a few notes. Wait till Monday.
Perry Wincourt, never change, man. Great actor. As is Bill Hader. Also, apparently, Bill Hader's daughter came up with the idea of Barry's, like, I think anxiety attack. It's either a panic attack or an anxiety attack. But she came up with the idea because, like, through her own experiences of panic attacks. And I think that's brilliant. He took inspiration from his daughter that I didn't know he had. I'm being straight up.
Why don't you give me a call?
Oh yeah, I just realized, Barry hasn't showered at all since what happened.
Amazing. I didn't even have to act. You just gave it to me, everything I needed. God, you...
Fuck off, Sally.
At least that's your new process, okay? All you have to do is do that every time.
Guy, keep killing people. I mean, he does that anyway. Oh, okay, that's it. Okay. I thought there was more than that. Okay, that was Barry episode 7. I have no notes. Right on to episode 8.
Come after us? I mean, fucking Chechens, right? They got no sense of personal responsibility. What?
Personal responsibility? Motherfucker, you told them that Cristobal was a bad dude. The fuck do you mean personal responsibility? Oh wait, that's kind of ironic since he won't take any personal responsibility. I get your subtlety, Bill Hader.
No, it's our money, buddy. That money is our money.
Bam. What? Get fucked, Fuchs. Barry. Chapter 8, Know Your Truth.
Barry's alive!
No way, Jose.
Yeah, no way, he's alive, and I can give him to you. Gordon, out of respect, I can leave.
Of course, he just tries selling Barry to Gordon.
I raised him like a son. Look at my fucking face. This tooth.
Shut up, Fuchs. You suck. But I applaud Steven Root because he's a fantastic actor.
That was Vasya. This is twin brother Ruslan.
I never realized that they were both played by the same actor.
Buddy. Come on.
It was at this point in the show I was like, yeah, fucking kill him. From a distance, that guy looked like Joel Kinnaman, and that guy looked like Chester Bennington. I don't know why that popped in my head. I don't know how I made that comparison either.
If weak, we will go. You will stay here and help Oksana with dishes.
Going on?
Got stuck on dish duty because he's an idiot.
He's going through acting class to find you. So I suggest you take your money and, you know, fly like Bug Bunny in Space Jam.
Fly like Bug Boy in Space Jam. I love NoHo Hank, but he's such a good character and good actor. I know I said that in the past. I love how Barry does not give a fuck about Fuchs.
Shit. Judge just signed a warrant to bring in Pizarre.
Gorm Pizarre, we're coming to get you.
Who's Pizarre? Or Pizarre? Oh, is that the twin?
What the fuck you doing?
Опа. Рука, рука, голова. И значит, он кричит об... Ой-я! Ой-я! Фукс, смотри на меня вот так. А я здесь вот смотрю.
I have no idea what he's talking about. I think it might be gibberish.
Милый мой, дорогой, посмотри, вот, Ваша, брат мой, дорогой. Вот традиция уже есть.
Again, stop stalling, please kill Fuchs. Even though I know he doesn't kill Fuchs. That's so far hilarious, but very, very, like, frightening.
Hey!
My hero!
Apocalypse now, motherfucker.
I love Loach.
I'm done with you. I'm done with all this starting right now.
That's the second time he said that.
Barry.
Man, I really wish I watched this as it premiered, or as it aired, because when I saw this scene, I'm like, oh, Fuchs is out of the show entirely until I watch season 2.
Frey, you know you're very polite. This is nice.
And thus starts the friendship term relationship of Hank and Cristobal.
You called me.
You cracked the case.
You owe me a swift kick in the balls. Ooh. K-U-R-O-S-A.
How are other people reacting to this? Just looking at TV like, why the fuck is the detective going on?
Look, Barry. What you did the other
day. Okay. It takes off the fucking plaque on the wall.
Oh my god, it was like a lifetime ago. But it's something I draw on a lot in my acting work. That's how I know that you went to the same place the other night.
Yes, he was hit by his girlfriend. Totally. Ow, my god.
That's true.
It's okay. It's a process. I understand. But you can't.
You understand that, but don't understand the fact that he was having a full-blown panic attack at the play.
Can't quit now. Do it.
You want to do a comedy with me?
Yeah.
We're going to call it Barry, and we'll have some sad undertones to it. It'll be fun. Then the dread starts in episode 7.
Let's do it.
Okay, yay.
That sounds awesome.
Okay, so...
And this is where I actually thought the episode ended, and this next part confused the hell out of me when I first watched it.
So we'll start rehearsing.
I got most of the words right, though, yeah?
Yeah, it's good. Yeah, it's getting there.
I'm not joking. I legit questioned if this was a dream sequence again, because it was like the whole show, it baits you in like, oh, Barry's gonna get the happy ending, but something bad turns out. And here I'm like, oh, I don't trust it at all. It's a dream, right? But as we soon come find out, it was not a dream.
It's a cozy little place, babe. And this is the poster for the new show.
Yeah.
That is a nice poster, but you can tell it that his face for like press release or some shit. It's both their faces for like press releases. But good poster. Good fake poster.
We Jerry Block.
Oh, that's my stage name. Yeah. It's catchier than Berkman.
Oh, is it? So
yeah, that's where he fucked up, and even he realized that. I took a trip on a sailing. You know, it is nice seeing Barry genuinely happy. So, like, he's away from Fuchs, he's away from the mob, he's away from the Chechens, Bolivians. I don't know why I said an accent. He just seems genuinely happy, and it really makes what happens in the end of the episode really fucking sad.
And the cool thing is that Sally and I are going to switch roles every night. So one night we play the nutcase, the next night we play the square.
Oh, I remember I had to do that. I was in a school play. It was Annie Jr. I was the butler for one night, and then I was one of the dancers for the next night. And yeah, let's just say I could not dance. I could not do the choreography because... And I missed all the rehearsals for that part of the show because they just told me, "Oh, go to your rehearsals as the butler," and they didn't tell me anything else. So I may have fooled myself on a stage only filled with a cafeteria full of people. But I don't live it down. Damn it! I'm proud that I did something like that, and now I was never involved in a school play again.
Why? So, Barry, what's your endgame with this?
Endgame?
This is where I thought this would, like, the reality would break. Because Barry Larrard has, like, psychotic episodes where, like, he just imagines full-on scenes and they just don't happen. So this is the part, in my first time watching, I was just like, oh, shit.
Oh, crap. So the first time I saw this kid perform,
oh shit! This is where he truly finds out.
He improv too modest. I'm gonna train that right out of him.
He will too.
He's just like, please shut the fuck up, Cousineau.
Detective patrol.
Acting. She's interested in acting. Can you tell? She's a fucking actress. She tells us every goddamn minute she's on the screen. By the way, I am joking. I love Sally the character. I have said it multiple times.
We want love. We want a life. And we're doing it, Janice.
And by the way, Paula Newsom, I think that's her name, is such a great actress. I completely forgot to, like, mention her in any of my videos about Barry. Great actress. She really does make this first season way beyond a typical comedy. Like, she adds a lot of comedy and this scene, a lot of drama to it, along with all the other cast members.
Barry! Move.
Probably shouldn't probably shouldn't tell him to do that. You probably should have took your cups with you because Barry always has a plan B. And there it is.
It's done.
You're right. You're right. It is done. For you. There it is. The one scene that changed the whole fucking course of the show. I hate it. I love it, but I hate it at the same time because Barry doesn't learn his fucking lesson. And the way it comes in like it was nothing. He just comes in and gets back in bed. And now.
Starting now.
Yep. And right by Alan Berg. Alec Berg. Alright, that was episode 7 through 8 of Barry. Holy shit. Season 1, oh my god. I keep forgetting how fucking fantastic season 1 is. It starts out really slow, but really picks up the pace from episodes 5 to 8. And I absolutely love that. One of my favorite aspects of the show is obviously Barry. Barry is one of my favorite characters in TV. Because he's such a fucking complicated character. I love him. And you also, you hate to root for him. Especially in like the later seasons. You hate to root for him. But in this season, you can perfectly understand why he wants a normal life. I absolutely love that. But at the end of the day, like I've been saying throughout this entire series, Barry does not learn his fucking lesson. Thank you guys so much for watching this, videos of Barry. They don't do as well as my movie reactions, but I do not care because I love Barry and I love watching this show for the channel. I will be doing season 2, sometime next year. I have no idea. For right now, I have the next video coming out, this week. It's Harbinger's Resurrection Reaction. That's a mouthful to say, but, the album reaction that's coming out on and hopefully Friday. Please, hopefully Friday. And then Sunday is the holdovers. So, till then, I'm Zach Roseman. And remember, if you're a hitman and want a normal life, maybe don't kill people.